In this episode, we're identifying the connections of our motherboard.
You're watching IT Pro TV.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in as we continue our journey down a hands-on PC build. And prior to putting everything together inside of the system unit, I thought it would be a good time to just take a look at the anatomy, what makes up our motherboard, and just become familiar with and be able to identify some of the connections. And we're actually using our Gigabyte. This is the Z390 gaming export. It's what we'll be using in our build here. So a couple of things that came in the box. We've got our owner's manual, which you can also find online too. We'll post the link to it in the show notes so that if you have maybe want to follow along with us, you can. Got a couple of other screws and bolts. We got a standoff for the M2 drive and a screw to fasten it in place, and a couple of serial ATA or SATA cables, and then of course the all-important post-build routine. We've got our optical disc here, which contains our chipset drivers for when we install our operating system. So that's kind of what came in the box. That's the unboxing. Once you say, we go ahead and we take a look at the board. Now, we've got various components inside of our board, and one of the things that we really want to look at first is we want to look at some of the connections that we can make here. And if we kind of start up here, you're going to see that we've got a series of PCIe slots, these smaller ones here being the single lane PCIe slots. And then we've got a couple of these larger ones here, and these are the 16 lane slots that we can use as well. And then just beyond, just to the left of the M2 socket here, we've got another PCIe slot. So these are all the places where we can expand the functionality by adding additional cards. Now, I kind of mentioned that this is the M2 socket. It's actually got a heat spreader on it. We're going to be looking at that when we decide to install one of our SSDs. And you can see this little plastic bar along the top here. We'll be taking a look at that a little bit later when we start making some connections, our peripheral connections. That's the back panel. It's typically what you see on the back side of your PC. Now, a couple other things that we have. We have our voltage regulator modules here, and then we have our 1151 LGA socket. That's where we're going to install our i5 processor coming up. Some other things that we see on the motherboard here, you're going to see up in the upper right-hand corner there, that is actually our 12-volt CPU connector, and you can see the connectors there. Now, a little bit hard to see right here, but if we kind of shine a light on it, you're going to see that there are four pins right there. Those four pins are actually one of the system fans, and if you have multiple system fans, that's where you can make one of the connections. And if we come just beyond this little heat sink here, you're going to see there's another four-pin connection here. That's actually our system fans. I take that back. It's not a system fan. That's actually the CPU fan here. Now, down here, we have our DIMM slots. That's where we're going to install our DDR4 system memory or DDR4 RAM. And along the bottom here, we have our 24-pin ATX power connector. We also have our USB 3.0 header here too, so if we're going to support the USB 3.0 ports, we would make the connection right here. And then, last but not least on this side, we have our second system fan. So you'll see a couple of system fans, including the CPU fan, is here likewise too. And then these ports right down here at the bottom, these are our serial ATA ports. So far what we've identified is some of the major components. We've looked at all of the expansion slots, the PCIe slots that we're going to be using, or not using, depending on what we install on the in the system build. We've also looked at some of the power connectors, as well as that 1155 socket, that LGA socket where we're gonna actually install our i5 processor. We've seen DDR4 slots, the main power connectors, and some of the system fans. Now, what do you say we go ahead and we will kind of go to the other half of the globe here, and let's look at the other half of the memory board, and we'll look at some of those as well. So let's check those out. All right, we've taken that journey to the other side of the globe. Well, maybe the other side of the motherboard here. And on this side, what we're seeing is one of the first things at the top of the board, that's actually a front panel audio. And when we say front panel, think of the front of your case. When you plug into, let's say, speakers into the front of your computer, maybe it's a headset and microphone. Well, that's what we talk about when we say front panel audio. Just below that, you're going to see this little three-pin connector. That's the Sony Philips digital interface. Right below that, We have some COM ports, kind of legacy, if you will, but they're still putting them on these motherboards today. Then we also have something that's really just more for aesthetics, or if you will, or just some flair, and that's the LED ribbon that you can actually plug into this motherboard and give it a little bit of color. Right below that, you're going to see that there is a TPM slot. That is your trusted platform module, so if you want to increase the security. Then over here, you actually have a second M2 SSD mounting point right here. We've already kind of seen this one, and this one's got a heat sink or a heat spreader over it. This one doesn't come with a heat spreader, but that's just the mounting position. And then right here we have our front panel for our USB, our front panel USB headers here too. So think about where you plug your USB into the front of the case. Below that, kind of in that same vein, well, I tell you what, we'll get to this one right here. This is a third system fan header, so we're up to three system fans, and that's not including the fourth one, which is the CPU fan, so that's another one of those. And then right here, this is where we have our front panel headers, this little colorful thing here. It's actually color coding and letting us know how we should arrange these. And we're going to be looking at that later on in the series too. Think of that as your drive indicator light when you have activity on your hard drive, or really when you push power on your computer, it powers your computer up. And then you start to see the power LED light. That's where these are, as well as the reset button. And speaking of reset, just behind that, there's these two little pins here. That's actually your CMOS reset. You can clear your CMOS if you need to. And then this big thing that we see right here, that's actually your Intel Z390. That's the chipset for the motherboard. So these are some of the components and the slots and the connections that we can make on the motherboard. And it's important to kind of identify them prior to moving forward in your PC build if you're not aware of what they are. Now, this is our Gigabyte Z390 gaming export. This is the one that we chose for our build. Remember that yours can vary slightly, and that's okay. And the arrangement might be slightly different. For the most part, though, most of the motherboards have just about the same connections, how many connections, what they technology they support, that does differ. So again, pay attention to those vendor instructions. But that's what we looked at in this episode, identifying some of the connections you can make on your motherboard prior to building your PC.
Thank you for watching IT Pro TV.